Hello dear students, in the last class we had discussed the capacitance of parallel plate capacitor and we had also seen the energy stored in the capacitor. Now today we shall continue the topic and today we will derive the expression for capacitance of a coaxial capacitor. Okay, so today we have to derive the capacitance expression for capacitance of a coaxial capacitor. Coaxial capacitor. Okay. So let us consider a coaxial cylindrical capacitor of length L, of inner radius small a and outer radius small b, and let the space between the conductors be filled with a homogeneous dielectric with permittivity epsilon. Okay, so let me first represent it diagrammatically so that it would help us better to do the derivation and understand the concept also. So this is a coaxial capacitor. Okay, so let this is the okay. So this is a coaxial capacitor. Okay, the length is L. And the dimensions are, the inner radius is small a and the outer radius is small b. Okay, this one is small b. Fine. Now the region between the two conductors, that is with radius a and radius b, the region between these two conductors are filled with a dielectric. Okay. So region between these two conductors are filled with the dielectric. This is filled with this dielectric with permittivity epsilon. Okay. So and this the charged one, so the charges are and this one is plus. So this is a charged capacitor. Okay, now we have considered this coaxial cylindrical capacitor of length this L, of inner radius small a and outer radius is small b. And the space between these two conductors are filled with a homogeneous dielectric with permittivity epsilon. Now let us assume that the conductors 1 and 2 carry plus Q and minus Q charges respectively. Okay. So assuming that the conductors 1 and 2, so this one is your 1 and the outer one is 2. Okay, so assuming that the conductors 1 and 2 carry plus Q and minus Q charges respectively. Okay, so we have assumed that this conductor 1 and 2 are carrying equal and opposite charge, that is plus Q and minus Q respectively. Now by applying Gauss law, by applying Gauss law. Okay, so by applying Gauss law we can write this Q equals to epsilon E dot ds. Okay, and now it can be further written as, since this electric field is in the direction of rho, we are talking about the cylindrical coordinates. Okay, so this E will be E rho. This is epsilon E rho, and we have this ds. Now what will be this integral? This is the curved surface area. Okay, so this is the curved surface area. Now if we assume the radius as rho, okay, if we assume somewhere the radius as rho and the length is L, so what is the formula for curved surface area of a cylinder? It's 2 pi radius into height. Okay, 2 pi RH. Fine. Let's say if there is one cylinder of height is your H and this radius is R. So what is the curved surface area of this cylinder? CSA, we write 2 pi RH. Okay, so it is very well known to us. So now in this case, if we are considering this coordinate, this radius along this rho, then obviously 2 pi rho into H, and H is your L. So this can be further written as epsilon E rho and what? 2 pi rho L. 2 pi rho L. Okay. Now from here, what is E? This E rho will be equal to what? This Q upon 2 pi epsilon rho L. And the direction is along rho direction, so we can write this A rho. Okay. Now, moving on, what is the relation between V and E? Almost in every lecture, we need this V equals to negative line integral of the electric field intensity. That is, from region 1 to 2, we have this E dot dl. Okay. Now, what is 1 to 2? 1 to 2 means radius A to radius B. Okay. If we see this region, this first conductor is at radius A and second conductor is radius B. So the limit of integration will be from, in this case it is V to A, because we are moving on from the second region to the first region. Okay. Minus, and then E. What is the value of E? We have derived here Q upon 2 pi epsilon rho and L. The direction is A rho. Okay. And dot of this dl can be written as d rho in the direction of this A rho. So now A rho dot A rho, what is? It is 1. And then this V equals to how much? This is Q upon and D rho from B to A. Okay. Q upon 2 pi epsilon rho L. Okay. And then if we solve this integration B to A. Okay. And this minus of D rho. So from here, what is V? So V equals to, if we do the integration, this rho cannot be taken out. Okay, this rho cannot be taken out. So 2 pi epsilon L we can take, and the remaining integration, that is 1 upon rho d rho, because this integration has to be done with respect to rho. So by mistake it was taken out, but it has to be retained inside. Okay. and the integration limit is from this B to A, and here it is minus. Okay, so from here if we solve it, so B equals to how much? 1 upon rho means ln rho. Now if you put the limit, then it will be ln of this A upon B. Okay, and if we take this minus sign inside, then it is ln of B upon A. So the formula will be Q upon 2 pi epsilon L ln this B upon A. Okay, so this B equals to Q upon 2 pi epsilon N ln B upon A. Now we have determined this B, that is just now we have determined Q upon 2 pi epsilon L ln B upon A. Now what is capacitance? So the formula for capacitance is, and at present we are determining the capacitance of a coaxial cylinder. Okay, so capacitance of a coaxial cylinder, that is C equals to given by Q upon V. So if you put this, this Q upon and the value of V, Q upon 2 pi epsilon L ln B upon A. Okay, so this will be here, this C will be, this Q and Q will be cancelled out, and 2 pi epsilon L will be in the numerator. So it is 2 pi epsilon L upon this ln B upon A. Okay, and this is the expression for capacitance of a coaxial cylinder in the units is farads. Now let's discuss the another capacitor, another type of capacitor. Okay, and we'll determine the capacitance as we determined for the parallel plate and coaxial. So the next stage is spherical capacitor. The next type is spherical capacitor. Okay, so spherical capacitor is the case of two concentric spherical conductors. Okay, with the same center and different radius. Right. So the consider the inner sphere of radius A and the outer sphere of radius B such that B is greater than A and separated by a dielectric medium with permittivity epsilon. Okay, the case is similar to what we discussed just now, that is the coaxial cylindrical capacitor, only the orientation, the shape is spherical here. Okay, and the rest things are same. Now we have assumed plus Q and minus Q charge on the inner and outer spheres. Okay, so let me try to explain it more clearly with the help of diagram. Okay, so let's say this one is the inner sphere and this one is the outer sphere. Okay, now the radius of this inner sphere is small a and radius of this outer sphere is small b. Okay, and they are charged capacitors. So let me put the charges on the two capacitors. Okay, now this one is your first spherical conductor and this one is your second spherical conductor, and the space between the two conductor is filled with a dielectric, with dielectric constant, that is permittivity epsilon. Okay. Now, what we are considering here? We have considered a spherical capacitor. Okay. And here you can see the two concentric spherical conductors. Concentric means with the same center and different radius. That is, one is small a, the radius of inner sphere, and the radius of outer sphere is small b, so that this small b is greater than a, and the space between this the two spherical conductors are filled with a dielectric with permittivity epsilon. Okay, now let us assume that the inner and outer spheres are carrying the charges plus q and minus q respectively. Okay, so let the inner and outer spheres have plus q and minus q charges respectively. Okay, now we will proceed in the same manner as we explained just now for the coaxial cylindrical capacitor. Okay, so by applying Gauss law, to an arbitrary Gaussian surface. Okay, so let's choose an arbitrary Gaussian surface. And this is of this radius small r. This arbitrary Gaussian surface of radius small r. Okay, so that this r is lying between this a and b. Okay, now if we apply Gauss law to this Gaussian surface, this one is a Gaussian surface. Okay, now we apply Gauss law to this Gaussian surface with radius small r, then what is q? Q is your epsilon e dot ds. Actually, through which formula I am writing this? You have studied q equal to surface integral of electric flux density. That is q equal to integral d dot ds. But d can be written as epsilon e, so we can write it like this. Okay, now this E is directed along this R. Okay, so we can write epsilon E R and this closed surface integral. Now tell me, if you have a sphere with radius R, then what will be the surface area? What will the surface area of a sphere? It is 4 pi R square. Okay, it is very well known to us. So we can write it E epsilon r into 4 pi r square. What is 4 pi r square? Because we have assumed the Gaussian surface with radius r, and we are applying Gauss law for that Gaussian surface. That's why we have taken this radius small r. Okay, now from here, what is er? If we talk about this, er equals to this q upon 4 pi epsilon r square. Okay, and the direction is along this ar. Okay, now again, the potential difference between the conductors, what is the relation between b and e? So b is this negative line integral of electric field density. So if we talk about from region 2 to 1, so here also we have the same case. That is, from B to A, and E dot dl. So what is E? E is your Q upon 4 pi epsilon r square, and the direction is AR. Okay, and dot dr AR, because this dl is directed along r direction. Okay, so dr dot AR. So AR dot AR is what? Dot product of the same unit vector, that is 1. So we'll proceed further. So V equals to, we can take this out, Q upon 4 pi epsilon. So minus Q upon 4 pi epsilon, and in the integration it is 1 upon r square and dr. Okay. Now what is the integration of 1 upon r square? It is minus 1 upon r. So this minus minus will be plus, and we'll solve it. So Q upon 4 pi epsilon, and when we put the limits, so it is 1 upon a minus 1 upon b, because the integration was minus 1 upon r and minus minus it is plus, and then we put the limits. So this one is your potential. So the potential is, just we have determined, that is Q upon 4 pi epsilon, and it is 1 upon A minus 1 upon B. Now the capacitance of the spherical capacitor is, so capacitance of the spherical capacitor. Spherical capacitor is given by, so this C equals to how much? This one is Q upon V. So if we put it, the value of this V determined just above, Q upon 4 pi epsilon 1 upon A minus 1 upon B. So this C will be how much? It cancel this Q. Then it is 4 pi epsilon upon this 1 upon A minus 1 upon B. Okay, so this is the expression for capacitance of this coaxial or two concentric spherical conductors or spherical capacitor.